Good day once again. My name is Graphics. Today we're looking at this exercise on resultant and resultant of forces. Now, if you look at this, we have four forces associated to this point. So we call this kind of force a concurrent coplanar force. Coplanar force in aspect that what? They are forces on the same plane. Concurrent means that what? They are passing through a common center here, right? So their line of action meet at this point called concurrence, but they are coplanar because they are on the same plane. Now, as you look at this, we have four forces associated to this diagram. We have force number one, which is 10, force number two, which is 5, force number three, 20, and force number four, 15. But we know that force number one, which is 10, is acting at an angle of what? 45 degrees to the horizontal. Force number 2 is 5 newton, is acting at an angle of what, 30 degrees to the horizontal. Can you see? 30 degrees. Force number 3 is 20 kilonewton, acting at an angle of 30 degrees also to the horizontal. Because why I say to the horizontal is inclined to the horizontal. And that is also 30 degrees. And force number 4, 15 newton, acting to the horizontal. Can you see? Is the horizontal, x axis is the horizontal, at an angle of what, 60 degrees. Now what you do is this, you are going to write your condition. The condition you write here will be that consider that all upward forces is positive. I mean, any force upward is what? Positive. Then also, all downward forces is what? Negative. So any force facing downward is what? Negative. And all forward force, or all force to the right, is what? Positive. And all force to the left is what? Negative. These are the conditions you have to align out. Is that okay? So after doing that, I need to understand that this force is inclined. And what am I going to do this for? I'm going to what? Resolute this force. That we'll call resolution of forces. Resolution of forces is whereby the inclined force is resoluted, is resolved into vertical and what? Horizontal components. Right? So what I'll do here is this. So I'm going to resolve this. Since it's inclined, I'll resolve it to the horizontal. And this will give me 10. Cos what? 45. That again. 10 cos 45. And also to the vertical. This will be 10 sine 45. I've resolved that first now. So I'll put it here. So this is horizontal because it's parallel to the x axis. So that is EH. You can call your EH your EF of X also. So I'm having 10 cos 45. Now it's going towards the right, so it is left to be what? Positive. Because I've already said it that all forward force is what? Positive. Now vertical force is also called summation of what? EF of Y or FY. So now it's facing up. And that is positive also. So I'll put 10 sine 45. Is that okay? Now, the next one is force number 2. Is at an angle of what, 30 degrees. I'm going to resolve the 2. So I have this going up. Right? So it will be, since it's vertical, it will be 5 sine what? 30. 5 sine 30, and here will be 5 cos 30. Is that the game? That will be 5 cos 32. So this is facing horizontal. The horizontal force, this is parallel to the x-axis, is 5 cos and it's facing left. So it will be minus 5 cos 30. Is that the game? Now, for the vertical force, this instead this inclined force here is what? Facing up, so positive. So we have positive 5 sine 30. So we'll go to the next force again. We'll do the same thing here. This coming down like this. And that will give me 20 sine 30. And that will give me 20 cos 30. Right? This will give me 20 cos 30. So now if you look at this, it's facing down here. The vertical, the horizontal force here is facing left. So it will be minus what? To be minus 20 cos 30. And here will give me, it's facing down. This guy here is facing down. So it will give me minus 20 sine 30. Now the next one will be this. I'll do the same thing here also. This will come this direction. And this will go like this. So this will give me 15 cos 60. Why it will give me 15 sine 60. So this is facing right, it's positive. So it will be 15 cos 60. 15 cos 60. And this is facing downward. The vertical force will give me minus 15 sine 60. Is that the key? The key word is that what? They are all inclined to the horizontal. If you watch my video, I gave you two situations where they are inclined to the vertical also. So now this is what we are having. Now after this, we're moving forward. We're moving forward. We've successfully gotten the table. Now we want to know the summation of all the horizontal components. So we know that for summation of what? For summation of EH, or you call it summation of F of X, that is the addition of all the horizontal components. So we have 10 cos 45. That is this 10 cos 45 minus 5 cos 30 minus 20 cos 30 plus 15 cos 60. So if you press our calculator, 10 cos 45, you'll be having 7.071. If you press 5 cos 30, you have minus 4.33. If you have 20 cos 30, it will give you 17.32 minus 17.32. So you have plus what? 7.5. Cos 15 cos 60, 7.5. So in the long run, when you add all this, you'll be having minus 7.079 kilonewton. So this is my what? Summation of what? F of X or H, right? So this is my what? This is my summation of what? F of X. Now the next one we have EV, or you call it summation of what? EF of Y. So in doing that, we'll come here and having this, so we know we have 10 sine 45, the first one. 10 sine 45, we're adding all the old vertical components. So we have 10 sine 45. The next one is what? 5 sine 30 minus 20 sine 30 minus 15 sine 60. Right? So in doing that, 10 sine 45 will still give me 7.071. Plus 5 sine 30 will give you 2.5. Minus 20 sine 30 will give you 10. Minus 15 sine 60 will give you 12.99. So when you add all this together, you'll be having minus 13.419 kilonewton. So this is my vertical component, or the sum of all the forces are non-vertical components, right? So we know very well that the resultant force is equal to summation of what? EH or EF of x squared plus summation of what? EV or EF of y squared. So we're going to substitute this value in. So I'll have my arrow to be equal to square root of, if I input EH here, if you look at it, this is EH or EF of x, and that is minus 7.079 minus 7.709. R square plus EV is minus what? 13.419 R square square root here. So if you push forward, let's move forward. Let's get here. Let us do it here. So if we push forward here, my resultant force will be equal to minus 7.709 square will give you 50.11. So that will give me square root of, this is 50.11 plus minus 13.419 to give us 180.07. So when you add both of them, you'll be having the square root of what? 230.18. So the resultant force will now give me 15.17 kilonewton. That is for the resultant force here. Now for the angle, we know very well that tan theta is equal to, so is equal to summation of V over summation of what? H. That means summation of vertical component over summation of horizontal component. And this will give me minus 13.419, that is for V, and all over what? Minus 7.079. Minus equals to minus, right? So we now see that my tan theta is equal to what? 1.896. So if tan is coming to the other side, it gives me tan inverse 1.896. So the theta here will now give me 62.19 degrees. So this is my angle here. So thank you for watching. So in the long run, this is what we have successfully calculated.